Hey guys, what's up? So let us discuss the tools of discipline that will help you become a more disciplined person in your life and will help you achieve great goals in your personal and professional career. So life of wisdom must be a life of contemplation combined with action. Without discipline, there cannot be any action. So let's get started. So the four tools of discipline which you need to know is delaying of gratification, that is sacrificing short-term gains for long-term goals. Acceptance of responsibility, that is you are responsible for your life, not anyone else, not your father, not anyone. Dedication to truth and balancing, that is you need to be honest and you need to balance your life. It is very easy to learn, very easy. Everybody can learn, very hard to employ, and these are the tools to confront problems and thus pain. It will help you avoid pain in the longer run. Delaying gratification, I have explained it infinite number of times in my willpower course as well. There was an experiment, marshmallow experiment in Stanford. Anybody who delays gratification for long-term goals will always succeed in life. It is a process of scheduling the pain and pleasure of life in such a way as to enhance the pleasure by meeting and experiencing the pain first and getting it over with. So for example, if you want to become an IAS officer and want to have a good life, you give pain to your body for 2 to 3 years by preparing very hard for civil services, and delaying gratification is the only decent way to live. Second is accepting responsibility. It is very emotionally uncomfortable. Most of the people don't want to accept the responsibility in their life, and they want to say that it is because of my father or my mother or because of my brother. That is not my problem. It is just like that. I can't change it. So if you say that you are a drug addict because your father was into drugs, see, all these things will not solve it. Unless you say this is my problem and it is up to me to solve it, nobody else is going to solve it for you. Because now you are recognizing it is your problem. So this is not caused by other people. Okay, it is not beyond your control. If it is beyond your control, you will not be able to do anything. So accept the responsibility that you will need to change. Then third is dedication to reality. Most of us think that we don't confront reality. We don't think that we should talk about the real terms. Most of us know that our friend will not be able to crack the exam. Still, we live in the delusion that he or she might be able to crack it. But you and I both know it is not possible. But we are not able to confront it. We are not able to see the reality. We think we will be able to do it. The more clearly we see the reality of the world, the better equipped we are to deal with the world. You need to realize this. Or truth is, or reality is always avoided when it is painful. Whenever you think that you are not capable enough, you will never confront truth, and that will lead to your demise. Okay. Then you to have such discipline, we need to be totally dedicated to truth. You need to look in the eye that you are not good enough and you will need to improve. Otherwise, you will fail really bad later on. You will need to balance. Balancing is basically means that you will need to be really flexible, and all spheres of the life you will need to balance. Personal life, professional life, spiritual life, mental life, physical health, everything needs to be taken care of. But since you are balancing so many things, you will have to give up on something. So balancing is a discipline, because you will have to give up on something. If you are giving 3 hours to your wife, you can't go and watch a movie in that time. Are you getting my point? So balancing will help, will make sure that you give up something. Then there are ways to boost discipline and be more productive. So let us see what these ways are. First of all, build very small habits. As I have told you, if you are not able to get up early in the morning for a run, just tie your shoes for first week. Then in second week, walk for 5 minutes. Then in third week, walk for 10 minutes. Then fourth week, walk for 15 minutes. Okay. Even this tiny, very small habit will change your life drastically. You will not get heart attack when you are 45. You will be thin, lean. Then engage in physical exercise as much as possible. Okay. Like, try to be physically active. Then meditation, I have already told you. It can decrease your stress, anxiety, depression, feeling of loneliness. It will boost your EQ. You will feel connected to the world. You will feel self-discipline, self-control. And obviously, it will improve your brain. It will get more positive emotions. And it will also improve your focus, attention, creativity, memory, and the ability to multitask. So try to use social media as an advantage. Like, the two things which I personally use, which work for me, is Google Calendar. Google Calendar is something which you should maintain, and you can see over a period of years that how it evolved. And Wunderlist is a to-do list app, and you can like really use it to your advantage. Try to use these two tools. It will change your life and it will make you much more disciplined. Then have a gratitude journal, like you write down whatever, like 5 minutes a day, like think about like how to help, like how you are helping others and how is life giving you back and so on and so forth. Then try a 7-minute workout app, okay? And it is the number one fitness app in 127 countries. It's your own personal trainer, and within 7 minutes you will be able to become fit. And try to discipline yourself. If you will discipline yourself to make your mind self-sufficient, you will thereby be least vulnerable to injury from the outside. So it is a very profound thought, just like think about it. And thank you for watching this entire course. I really had fun, and have an awesome day.